bed feels warmer, sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, bet you think that everything good is gone. Think you left me broken down, think that I'll come running back. Baby, you don't know me, cause you're dead wrong. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller, doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. What's that feeling?
It's like 6 something and I'm getting ready to go to the hospital and look who's come with me, my little surgeon daddy. Anyway, I will update you when I'm there.
Hi guys, so it's 8:20 and I'm at the Royal Free Hospital in London. Just got into my scrubs and some cool, sexy stockings. Just waiting to go down for my pacemaker operation. See you soon!
How are you feeling?
Cold. And these sexy tights kind of hurt.
Well, they look lovely!
My see-through knickers underneath.
Do you want to show us those?
No,
maybe not. No, okay.
It'll be a bit embarrassing.
Let's have a look around your room. Lovely room.
Nice and bright.
Dr. Surgeon. Oh, surgeon. Is he going to be performing the operation?
He's watching in on this one. He's not experienced.
Oh.
So.
This is Sophie, just returned about 10 minutes ago from her operation, having a very nice little sleep. One hour later and still fast asleep.
Surgeon Herman looking after her.
Got a drip on to give us a little bit of fluid. Herman having a little sleep too. Surgery was a bit much for him.
Hey guys, so the procedure went okay. I'm in a lot of pain, not gonna lie. It's already painful. But hopefully the morphine will kick in soon. I'll show you guys a site tomorrow maybe. Because it's all covered up right now with plasters and stuff. For bleeding and stuff like that, so maybe once it's off I can show you guys what it looks like. They showed me the pacemaker before they put it in, they bored it out, and it's like, it's really small, it's like that small maybe. It's like just a little bit bigger than a £2 coin, so it's pretty small. So yeah, all the nurses remember me from last time. I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. That could mean that I was like really bad last time and one of those people that they remember and they talk about after. And now I'm back. Just in time for Halloween to haunt them, so watch out, nurses. Watch out. Just a little bit. So it kind of feels like... a really bad stitch, I guess. Like, when you breathe, it's that kind of feeling, I guess, of a stitch. Like, similar to that, but a bit worse. So yeah, that's, I guess, kind of what to expect straight after you get it. Little Teddy here, been with me the whole time. He was a great help in surgery. He was telling the surgeons what to do. He was just directing, because, you know, his arms are a little bit short. So, really, he was doing all the hard work. But we'll give the surgeon this one. But, yeah. The surgeon said 70% success rate, and then the registrar today said 50 to 60. So I'm guessing it's somewhere between 50 and 70% success rate. And then my GI doctor said 60. I think. So yeah, I'm going to go for like 60% maybe that it will be successful. Complications were just the regular kind of ones, obviously, that they could perforate. Is that the word? Not very technical, which I think I should be by now. But yeah, just like that they can perforate it, obviously. Infection, bleeding, you can get fluid around the pacer site. Which isn't common, but it can happen. They could damage the bowel or the stomach wall when they're going in. But these were all like 5% chances, they said. So they're very, very rare.
That's Sophie on the following morning of her op, feeling a little bit sore, in pain. Managed a bit of egg this morning. Had a bit of a rough night, didn't you, Sophie? Yeah? Not feeling so good this morning? No. Okay. Had a little bit of a morphine cocktail, I hear, in the middle of the night. Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
How can you make it look so easy? What are you doing? How can you make it look so easy to get the gloves on?
Easy. What size is those?
Large.
We don't have a big
start,
I'm sorry.
Extra large.
Have you got scissor and a
dog? How was your ice cream, Sophie? Tell everybody how your ice cream was. So you managed to eat the whole bowl?
Yeah.
Okay then.
Hey guys, so it's day 2 after the operation. Had kind of a bad day yesterday. The pain was pretty bad. But today it seems pretty good. It's not really that much existence. Besides when I move, then it's like a little bit. But I can get up and I can walk. Yeah, but the pain is much better today. Much, much better. Which is a good sign, and hopefully I can go home today. So, yeah, it's looking good. I have my appointment booked for in 6 weeks' time when they change the settings. So hopefully that would allow me to eat that a little bit more, if it works. Someone asked about medical bracelets and if you're supposed to wear one or have any, like, carry anything on you so that people know that you have a pacemaker. And what I've been given is, I've put a picture in because I didn't actually have it with me. My mum has it at home. So it's like a little card. It's like, I can't think of the size. It's like not that big. It's quite small. And you get two. And it just has all your details on it and the fact that you have the neurostimulator. So as well as the cards that you also get a booklet. And in the booklet it says, like, your do's and your don'ts, like things like airport scanners that a lot of people know, and things that don't affect it but people think could, like heated blankets and microwaves and things like that. You know, in the end, the day you left is just a mild beginning. In the end, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. So it's day 5 after the operation, and I thought I'd give you an update. So the pain is a lot better. I'm only having like one lot of painkillers maybe a day. I can kind of feel where the pacemaker is, but you can't see it. I can just feel it, so I guess that's just getting used to it. And so far there's not been much improvement with it, but that's normal because it's on the lower setting and doesn't get turned up for 6 weeks. It's helping the sickness a little bit, like I'm not feeling that sick just during the day. When I eat, I'm still feeling sick, but the sickness passes faster than what it would before, but it doesn't touch the pain. The pain's still just as bad and it's still there. But hopefully that's looking good, that it will work, because it's helping the sickness die down faster and it's on the lower setting. So hopefully in 6 weeks when we turn it up, it will improve a bit. And then I can ask the rest of the questions that everyone's asked and tell you how that goes. Also, with my tube feeding, I mentioned earlier in the video that I was struggling to tolerate it. So we got them to check it in the hospital while they were doing the operation. And from what they could see, it's still in position. So that didn't really answer the question so well. So we're waiting on another test now, where they can 100% check it with, like, it's like an x-ray, but they put dye down the tube so they can see where the tip is as well, and see if that tells anything more, because it's got worse since I've had the operation. I now tolerate like an hour, and that's a struggle, and I'm finding it hard to put anything through the tube. Thanks for watching, and I hope the video has helped you, and any questions please just ask in the comments below or message me.